Thank you, Mr. President. I stand also to salute the Tuskegee Airmen, and thank you for taking time to come up to Albany today so that we could properly present you this proclamation and our expression of thanks for your service, not only during your time and in the service in the theater in World War II, where you definitely fought to be respected and fought to be given the opportunity to fly missions, where you fought to, and with the help of the President and Eleanor Roosevelt, to even be created. But even after you came back to home, you fought to become integrated in many neighborhoods. You came and you were civic leaders and activists in many areas. You were not just activists during the war, but you stayed activists afterwards. You stayed involved in politics and government and civic life. You were leaders in many areas. We have many Tuskegee Airmen that are in Queens, where we have in your college a testament to the Tuskegee Airmen, where we have a exhibition that is dedicated to the Tuskegee Airmen that I hope that we can improve and in finally get it off the ground where we can have all of the history of the Tuskegee Airmen in Queens. And to Mr. Colthurst, who I've known and I've seen over the time, and Denise Peace, who is here also, stand up, Denise, who is a daughter of a Tuskegee Airman, who is a powerful woman in her own right, that is a major person that is working in many different government agencies and has a great history and experience as well. I want to salute you, I want to thank you for your service, and I hope that your story can always be told to inspire other people. Thank you, Mr. President.